and a donkey. One sunny day, a man decided to go to the market in a town. He went to the stable and got this donkey.
The man's daughter looked outside and saw her father about to set off for a village. So she hurried outside.
Dad, Dad, where are you going? Can I come too?
I'm just going to the market. You can come if you want. Get your hat, it's a hot day.
Father, will we ride the donkey today?
No, dear. We won't ride him today, for it is a hot day, and he will have a heavy load to carry home from the market.
The man, the girl, and the donkey headed slowly down the dirt road that led to the town. After a short while, they met a group of farmers.
My, oh my, what do I see? A crazy situation right in front of me!
You fools! Don't you know that donkeys are for riding? You must be afraid to rub the fur off its body.
How ridiculous! You own a donkey but you don't use it? That makes you the ass!
What are you scoundrels scoffing at? My dear, get up onto the donkey.
Why didn't that farmer keep his mouth shut?
Soon, they came to a group of old men and women who were talking very earnestly.
My, oh my, what do I see? A crazy situation right in front of me.
That idle lout of a girl sits there in luxury while her poor old father sweats like a pig.
Aren't you ashamed of yourself, young lady? Your legs are young and strong, yet you let your father walk. Despicable!
The man wasn't a bit tired, but he said,
What are you vagabonds scoffing at? Get down, precious. I will take your turn riding the donkey. Then the people will be satisfied.
I was better off with the young Liz.
Pretty soon, they met some women coming from town.
My, oh my, what do I see? A crazy situation right in front of me.
Why, shame on you. How can you ride upon a beast?
Well, that poor little girl there can hardly keep pace by the side of you.
You lazy old fellow. What kind of man rides a donkey and leaves his poor little daughter to charge along beside him?
What are you old crow scoffing at? Dear, climb up here with me.
Double trouble.
They had not gone far when they came upon another group of passers-by who began to cheer, point, and heap more ridicule upon them.
My, oh my, what do I see? A crazy situation right in front of me.
Aren't you ashamed of yourselves for overloading that poor donkey? Someone should take a stick and knock the both of you off its back.
I agree. The poor animal can hardly walk. You two fellows look more fit to carry the poor beast than he is to carry you.
The man and the girl stopped the donkey once again and tried to think what to do. They thought and they thought. They had tried everything except carrying the donkey themselves.
Let us tie up the donkey's four hooves and put a pole on our shoulders so we can carry him to the market.
What a way to go! I'm dizzy. Woo!
There was the donkey going to the marketplace upside down. From all sides, people came running and laughing. Never had I seen such an entertaining sight.
Girl, is it noisy?
The donkey was upset by all the noise, so it started to struggle and wiggle just as they stepped on a market bridge. He got one hoof loose and kicked at the girl.
Ouch! Cut that out!
The girl dropped her end off the pole. The donkey walked up the bridge and into the water.
Splash!
Before anyone could fish him out, he drowned.
I have tried to please everybody, and I've only made a fool of myself. After this, I should do as I think best and let people say what they will.
Try to please all and you will please none.